All right, welcome to the NSCAA Google Plus Hangout on Air featuring Donna Fishter of Donna Fishter Consulting. Today we will discuss Leadership 360, leading yourself, leading others, and following the leader. This topic will be presented by Donna at the 2014 NSCAA Summer Symposium this July 31st through August 2nd in Orlando, Florida. Registration for this event is available online at nscaa.com/symposium. All right, so welcome, Donna. Thanks for joining us today.
Thank you.
Why don't we go ahead and get started? Give us a little bit of background on yourself and letting us know how Donna Fishter Consulting got started.
Yeah, for sure. I've been a soccer coach for over 18 years at all levels of the game, from youth all the way to college. Most recently, a year ago, I finished up 13 years at University of Central Florida. And besides, you know, all your normal assistant coach duties, I spearheaded the leadership development and the development of our team culture there for the 13 years. And so that was an amazing time. In 2011, I became a founding partner of the John Maxwell Coaching Team. He, for those of you who don't know, he's an internationally recognized leadership expert, works with the U.S. military, Fortune 100 companies. And so he started a coaching team where he certifies people to teach his content. And I'm one of his fans. He's sold 21 million books, so I jumped in on that because leadership is something I'm really passionate about. The way Donna Fishter Consulting started about a year ago, my head coach, Amanda Cromwell, took the UCLA head coaching position, and I turned down a fabulous job to start this business. This is my dream job, so to speak. There's something about when you figure out what your strengths are and what you're passionate about, and when those intersect the needs that you see out there, that's where you need to sit. And for me, I saw this immense need to be influencing the student athletes that are right in front of us. There's a study done years ago that shows it was the top 10 influencers in young people's lives, and coaches came in at number 3. That was way before moms and dads, and actually was the first human being that was on the list. So I kind of took that as, wow, like, we have as coaches, we have a huge responsibility. And I just saw this intangible side of the game as something that was critical to success.
Okay, well, thanks for that. At the upcoming symposium, you're giving a presentation called Leadership 360. Can you tell us and what attendees at that event can expect from this session?
Yeah, sure. Leadership 360, basically, it applies to everyone. It applies to coaches, players, administrators. But specifically, my frame of reference is going to be coaches and how coaches can specifically empower and train their leaders. Leadership 360 in a nutshell is this. Number one, the first person we lead is ourselves. Like, we're all leaders. It's not about authority, a title, or the armband in our sport. It's about influence. So the first person we have to influence is ourselves. Okay, so lead yourself. Second is we lead others within our sphere of influence, and that can be a few, it can be many, it can be a team. And then it comes full circle. The best leaders are always good followers. Like, leaders know how to follow one another and kind of how for the bigger picture, the bigger cause. So that's how Leadership 360 comes full circle, is just we're following well also. So, I mean, basically, you know, for me, leadership on a team, it captains, it's more than just the coin toss, right? Your job as a captain is more than just going up and doing the coin toss and starting warm up for coach. And that's kind of what I'm going to go into, is what should coaches expect from their leaders on a daily basis? What should be their responsibilities? And then how can we as coaches train them and impact them and continue that throughout the season and even in the off season? What should they be doing?
Okay, thank you. You gave a really exciting session at the convention this past January in Philadelphia, and it was with Michelle Akers and Amanda Cromwell, so packed room, full of energy. Talk to the group here a little bit about that experience for us.
Yeah, I mean, it was fantastic to have two people that are huge influencers in my life there in the room with me. And basically, what we talked about was just team culture and how, you know, we can be intentional about shaping and molding the culture on our teams, because it does have a huge impact in our success. And so Amanda, you know, obviously being at UCLA, and she talked a little bit about their run to the national championship and how their focus on team culture and their leaders, was very strategic and totally was a huge piece to the puzzle in their winning that national championship. And we took it, into leadership and how leadership is a critical aspect of building that culture. Because for me, leaders create the culture on their team. So Mish was able to bring a perspective from, the best in the world from that level as to how leaders impacted what her team did on a daily basis and influenced her. So it was really impactful. What I loved most about the whole experience was just the response to the content. The coaches were just responding with this excitement about the topic, and I really believe it proves that there's a need for this conversation in coaching, and that was one of the key points that I pushed, is that we need to rehumanize what we do as coaches, because as Pat Summitt said, the great head coach, from Tennessee basketball, she said, "You win with people." And I think sometimes we lose that. We lose that as coaches, is that, it's so much about the X's and O's and everything about strategy and tactics. But at bottom line, it's people. 18 to 22-year-olds that are out there, for college, that are going to win. And so how can we be intentional about shaping and molding people with everything that they bring to the table, to help them perform better and win? Bottom line is get the W. So I totally enjoyed the convention, and I'm looking forward to the symposium here in August.
Right. Well, the importance of the conversation, absolutely, on leadership, and you're considered an expert on team culture, player development. So how is leadership to you an integral piece to making this successful for teams and for coaches?
Right, well, in a nutshell, I believe that everything rises and falls on leadership. That is John Maxwell's mantra, and I totally embrace that and totally believe that. There's a lot of people that'll say, "Well, the old adage is your team is only as good as your weakest link," right? But I don't agree with that. I think your team is only as good as your leaders are, right? Because they're the ones that are out in front, and they're the energy to your team. So, I mean, the best picture of this that I can paint is after my first fall at UCF in 2000, we didn't have the success that we wanted that particular season, and so I went into Amanda and I said, you know, Coach, we have captains and we have leaders, but I'm not sure specifically they know everything that they need to be doing, you know. And so she knew my passion was leadership and being that people person, and she allowed me to take off with this. And so we began way back then to be intentional about empowering our leaders and training them in this whatever was relevant to that particular time on our team. And I think our results at UCF in the 13 years, 14 years that we were there proved that. Our final ranking in 2000, national ranking, was 145th. And in 1 year of being intentional, an important piece of the puzzle, leadership and team culture, in 1 year we cut that in half. And then continued to grow, had a couple setbacks, but since 2009, UCF is ranked in the top 25. And obviously lots of things come into play with that, but Amanda and I will both tell you that our being specifically intentional and investing in our leaders was key to that success. So, I mean, it's leadership is top on priority, in my opinion.
Right, thank you. So with this topic of conversation, what do you hope that the attendees at the Summer Symposium will take away most from this presentation?
You know, I would say probably just the awareness that we need to be selective of who our leaders are. We need to see who's having influence already, whether it's on our teams, whether it's positive or negative, and then how we can be involved in helping that situation as coaches. And so I want coaches to be able to walk away with a couple tools in their toolbox of content and say, okay, yeah, I can start with this, this, and this in training my leaders because it's going to impact us, you know, as a whole entire culture. The old saying, some coaches, you know, we use the excuse of, well, you can lead a horse to water, but you can't make him drink. Okay, so sometimes, you know, we all throw up our hands and it's like, well, I don't have any team leaders, you know, but I don't agree with that statement. See, you can put salt in the horse's mouth and you can make him thirsty, right? So there is always something that you can do, and so that's what I want people to walk away with, is a couple things that they can immediately be intentional about, impacting their teams and their leaders.
Okay. So if coaches or teams did want to work with you in Donna Fishter Consulting, how would they go about doing that, and what is it that you can provide them specifically?
Yeah, for sure. They can just shoot me an email just connect with me that way. I mentor and help coaches one-on-one in brainstorming just different ideas. So the great thing, obviously, with technology that we're experiencing here is with Skype and different things like this, I can be 1,000 miles away and be helping out a coach. So there's that way. I also will travel to a school or a soccer club and spend, you know, a day and a half, 2 days with a team. Working with their team as a whole, just inspiring them to greatness, motivational, how to connect with each other, the beginnings of culture, values, and then usually I'll spend quite a bit of time with just the team leaders and the coaches together of how they can begin to shape their culture on their team. So there's lots of different ways, and it depends on the needs of a team. You know, every team is not, it's not cookie cutter. Because we're human beings and we're people, every team's different because we're all different people. So, you know, I build custom strategies and different things like that. So, yeah, just shoot me an email. DonnaFishter.com is my website. You can find out more about the things that I do. I have a Facebook page you can see some pictures of different places that I've gone already these past couple months.
All right, great. All right, now so we're going to take some questions from our audience. The first question that came to us is from Julie Eibensteiner. What's the number one way to keep your entire roster engaged in this process and feel like they're contributing as well?
Julie, very good question. It's tough. It's tough, but I would encourage you to actually go back and watch my convention presentation, because I talk quite a bit about the people factor and valuing people. Basically, when you have a big roster, yeah, you need those bottom 10, and we're all coaches here, so I'm just going to call it what it is. The bottom 10, we need them to be better. So creating ways to value them is important. Number one, first and foremost, is, you know, we've got to connect with our athletes and build those relationships, because they're going to run through a brick wall for you at that point, right? But secondly, there's tons of different ways that you can create value systems or show that they matter, okay? Which is, there's one thing that you can start is I call it honor shields, where, and it can be relevant to your mascot, but it literally is the same concept as college football teams. They have the stickers on their helmets, and you basically come up with a objective criteria, but it's not just, okay, well, if you score a goal, you get one, because, well, that's your job, but it's, you know, scoring in the first 5 minutes of a game or the last 5 minutes of a half, because those are important moments, scoring on a set piece. Then just public praise of extraordinary acts of rightness. When a kid does something right, like, announce it, tell the whole team. I mean, those are the things that are going to let people know, or let your players know, that they're valued, even if they don't have their boots on the grass, you know, when the clock is running.
Okay. Next question is, do you think it's more important to instill leadership roles at the youth or collegiate levels, and which is more challenging?
Wow, that's a good question. I would say it's important at the youth level to have the kids understand that we're all leaders, that we have to lead ourselves, you know, basically the whole 360, that everybody's a leader, and then being other-centered. So at the youth level, being other-centered, because that's what true leadership is. At the college level, I would say, is when you start getting into specifics. With you're going to be dealing with more things like, well, how do I have that tough conversation with one of my teammates, and they're not going to like what they hear, right? But as a leader, I still have to have that conversation. And the best way to communicate, and there's so many more things at the college level that you know, you have to be thinking about, because everybody's growing, everybody's figuring out who they are more. So hopefully that answers that. Youth level is more everybody's a leader, how to do that, and then in college it's more relevant to the situation and specifics.
Okay. And last question that we have In your years around the game of soccer, is there one person whose leadership skills have impressed you or stood out in your mind the most?
Wow. I mean, there's so many, really. Of course, my boss, Amanda Cromwell. She's fantastic at just letting people and me and her assistants do what we're best at. And so that's big time leadership right there. I would say another person that comes to mind, ironically, is Josh Walters, who was also on staff with us. He spent, lots of years in Afghanistan, in the Army, and so. But specifically about Josh, I would say he is the epitome of other-centered, where he specifically is intentional about, okay, well, what is Donna passionate about, and how can I help Donna grow in that and become better? So that for me is big time leadership.
Okay, thank you. All right, well, that's all we have for today. Thanks again, okay. Donna, for everything that you've contributed to us. Make sure to check her out again at donnafishter.com. A live chat recording will be available of this session right here on nscaa.com/live. If you want to view any of our other archived live chats, you can go to nscatv.com and check out our video section. So thank you again for your time today. You can catch Donna live at the 2014 Summer Symposium, July 31st through August 2nd in Orlando, Florida. She'll present on Leadership 360 and also participate in a panel discussing mental skills with Tiffany Jones, Lynn Kashmarek, and Tony DiCicco. Registration is online at nscaa.com/symposium. Thank you again, and we'll see you next time.
All right. Thank you.